Hey guys, some of you may not remember what I look like because we haven't seen each other in a little while, but it's Warren Austin McGraw here. And I wanted to thank you guys for the amazing training year that we've had so far, even though it was cut a little bit short. Who would have known? But even though there's a pandemic, it doesn't stop us from trying to enjoy ourselves, like keeping in touch with our friends. And now that school's over, we can try new things. So, talking about trying new things, today, I'm filming this video right now, and I wasn't quite sure when I was going to film this that my uniform was going to fit, because a lot of us haven't worn these in a little while. So I'm giving you a little challenge to try on your uniform and just to see if it fits. And after then you can laugh about it, take a picture of yourself, send it to some friends, because why not? It's fun. Anyway, I just want to tell you guys how happy I am that we had the chance to know each other and to get to know each other and become friends over like my time here at Cadets. So I hope that you guys have an amazing summer, that you have fun, you stay safe, and I hope that we can see each other soon.
Fellow cadets, officers, friends, and families, I'm Warrant Officer Second Class Cunningham. When I first joined Cadets, I was extremely nervous and I had no idea what to expect. I thought that Air Cadets was scary, where they forced you to fly fighter jets and do push-ups all the time. I had no idea on the first night that I was starting a fulfilling journey full of fun, learning, experience, and growth. Cadets has always been a fun place for good days and a safe place for sad days. Even though I joined 2 years late, I still get the best experience that a cadet could have gotten, and I'm extremely thankful for it. Cadets has a great range of things for everyone, with music, drill, biathlon, marksmanship, model building, flight simulator, flying scholarship, effective speaking, survival, leadership, and a lot of other excellent skills and activities. Personally, I mainly took part in the music, drill, biathlon, effective speaking, and aviation programs throughout my 4 years of 161. Being in the squadron band kept me musical when I otherwise didn't have much time to dedicate to music, as I did in middle school. Being a part of the drill team taught me the importance of teamwork, as well as building my confidence in drill voice, which led to my 3-year reign as a unit drill team commander. I was in biathlon in level 4, but in that year I gained a lot of muscle, made a bunch of new friends, and I started to become less of a couch potato like I used to be. Effective speaking broke a huge barrier for me, because while I did do public speaking in middle school, I was never comfortable with it until I took part in the Cadet Effective Speaking program. The survival aspect of cadets was not something that caught my eye in the first place, but I remember the first field training exercise I went to in 2016, and that sparked my interest in that part of the program as well. I must say that some of the best moments of cadets were playing capture the flag against Captain Finney. But overall else, my favorite part of Air Cadets is the aviation part. The first gliding weekend was the moment that I realized I wanted to become a pilot. In level 3, I started attending ground school classes, and the interest only grew. In level 4, I went through the application progress for the glider pilot training course, and I still remember the awe and excitement I felt that night when I got accepted for glider. The excitement grew and grew, and all of a sudden, I was in DeBert, Nova Scotia for a seven-week pilot scholarship course. If you ask me how long that course felt like, however, I would probably say it was about 1 or 2 weeks. It flew by, no pun intended. Every moment of flying, pushing gliders, and of course drinking water without stopping, was filled with fun, energy, and excitement. The feeling of flying a glider for the first time was surreal. It is not a feeling anyone could ever replicate, and I got that feeling, the feeling I got was because of my years of hard work and dedication to Air Cadets. In conclusion, Air Cadets doesn't only teach you how to fly a plane or how to lead or how to play an instrument. Intertwined through the entire program is how to work as a team, how to tie a tie, how to iron your pants, how to present yourself, and how to learn effectively while having a great time and making memories with great new friends. The cadet program has taught me a great deal of skills that I will use to my advantage as I move on to university and my career in aviation, and I hope every one of us keeps learning like I have through the good times and memorable moments for years to come. Thank you, 161. I will always be grateful for my cadet experience, and it's all because of you.
How's it going, 161? Warrant Officer Eldridge here. Doing my graduation speech for all of you, and gonna tell you a little bit about my experience with cadets and some things I enjoy, some things I didn't enjoy. And lastly, some advice to all of you new cadets that might be joining in the next years to come, and all of you cadets that are just starting out. So with cadets, I've definitely grown a lot. So I've become more disciplined. I've become way more organized. There have been so many good things that come out of cadets. I made some awesome friends. Like Warrant Officer McGraw, Warrant Officer Buck, Warrant Officer Cunningham, Warrant Officer Abijayab, Flight Sergeant Abijayab. All those people are good friends of mine, and I made all but one through cadets. So it's been one heck of a ride, and we've done so many fun things together. We went to the water park on our Ottawa trip. We've been to biathlon competitions. We've been to Halifax all together. We've been so many fun places that we could just hang out as friends. In places that we generally don't get to visit, living out here in New Brunswick, that are really fun to visit when you're with your friends. We had one heck of a time at the water park. Myself, Warrant Officer Buck, Warrant Officer Cunningham, and Warrant Officer Luttrell when he was here. We all went into this big raft slide, and we had a lot of fun at the water park. And we all hung out, and we all got to be the teenagers, and we all got to be hang out as friends like we have always wanted. So that's been one of the highlights of my cadet career, so to speak. If somebody would have told me when I started that I would be, squadron adjutant and warrant officer second class, I would have called you crazy. I've proved myself wrong, and I've really been opened up to what I can do if I put my mind to something. I've generally like to think that I've given a lot of effort into cadets, and I've gotten by giving a lot of effort, I've gotten so much out of it. So that's actually one of the biggest pieces of advice I can offer to anybody, any cadet that's joining in the next couple of years, or any cadets just starting out. In the cadet program, there's a saying that goes around, and it's, you get out of the program what you put into it. So if you're going to be in the program and you're going to put no effort in, it's going to be not as fun for you. Might even be a little bit boring for you. But if you're in the cadet program and you put a lot of effort, you do your best to make every training night, you participate in optional training activities, you really take the information that you learn in class to heart, if you do all those things, then the cadet program is probably going to be one of the couple of best years of your life. As it has for me, I've been able to do so many things through the cadet program that I never thought would be possible to do if I weren't. How many people can really say that they got to live on a military base for a couple weeks and fly in military aircraft? And how many teenagers can say that they've flown in a military helicopter and they've flown with the military? Not many teenagers can say that, and those are really opportunities that you get through the cadet program. You can only get through the cadet program. So some advice that I want to give to the cadets that are coming up in the next couple of years. Number one, as I said, you get out of the program what you put into it. Put in the effort, you put in the time, then the cadet program is going to be really enjoyable for you. If you don't, then it's going to be the opposite. Another piece of advice I want to give to you new cadets and cadets that are just starting out. You may encounter some situations where you have to make a choice, whether it's going to be cadets or whether it's going to be school, family, or friends. And it's going to be a hard decision whether to go, you got selected for biathlon, you're going to go compete in biathlon competition, but it's also your friend's birthday party that weekend that you want to go to. Those are some decisions that are going to be hard for you, but one of the best things about the cadet program is that you can be a little bit flexible. And just because you're in the cadet program and your time is occupied a lot of the time, doesn't mean that you have to turn your back on everything else that's in your life. The best thing is to balance your school, to balance cadets, and to balance your friends and family all together. If you can balance those three things together, then it's going to be a breeze. If you can't, then things are going to be hard. But balancing those three things together will always make sure that you spend time with all three and you have success in all three. You spend time with cadets, you have success in cadets. You spend time with school, you have success in school. You have spend time with your friends and family, you have success, and you build relationships with them. So just because you're in the cadet program and your time is occupied doesn't mean you turn your back on school and friends and family and all that as well. And then the last piece of advice I want to give to the new seniors, so level 3 is coming into level 4, and level 4 is moving up to level 5. I think one of the biggest things is when you move into these positions, and some of you will be moving into pretty higher positions, squadron commander, squadron adjutant, squadron warrant officer, deputy squadron commander, all these higher up positions, the top 5 positions of the squadron or top 4. The best thing to remember, even though you might have these positions and you might, you will have authority, but don't forget that the cadet program is still supposed to be fun for you as well. So just because you're in a position of authority and just because you are a leader in the squadron, that does not mean that you still can't have fun at all. Gliding trips, squadron trips, sports nights, regular training activities. Don't forget that you're still a cadet too, and you are still able to have fun. So make sure that with great power, it comes with great responsibility, but make sure that responsibility and those tasks that you need to complete are balanced with everything else. So you need to make sure that you still have fun in the cadet program, because if you become a senior and you become come into one of these bigger positions, and if you don't have fun and you just focus on doing that position, then it's not going to be fun at all. But if you go into this position and you also make sure that you have fun, it's going to be a fun time. So that's probably one of the biggest pieces of advice I can give to new seniors, is even though you have responsibility and you have authority now, that still does not mean you can't have fun. So make sure you make the most of every moment in the cadet program and make sure that you take up every opportunity that you can. There are a couple times where I've passed over a couple opportunities and I really regret it now. I didn't regret it at the time, but now I really regret it. So make sure you take up every opportunity you can. Really proud of how you guys have progressed over the past couple of years. Level 3 is coming into level 4 and level 4 is coming into level 5. You guys are going to do an amazing job as a senior team. I have total confidence in you guys. And I'm really looking forward to coming back next year as a civilian volunteer and seeing how all of you guys get to work together. And so you're stuck with me for another year, but I won't be in this uniform. But you guys will still get to see this beautiful face for another year. So make sure, guys, you seize every moment. Make sure you take up every opportunity. Make sure you have fun in the program, and the program will make it fun for you.
Hi, guys. It's WO2 Abu Jayab. I hope you guys are doing well. No one expected us to end the year off like this, but let's look at the bright side. I get to practice my graduation speech a million times and only show you the best one. I guess it's only for me. Anyways, I want to thank the cadet organization for giving me the opportunity to grow and develop as a person, gain new skills, new friends, and new memories that I'll never forget. A piece of advice to my juniors is to not to say no too quickly. Always try new things. You really don't know until you try. So experience everything while you can. I want to say thank you again for all the officers and fellow senior cadets that helped make this year a very good year. And I will never forget my time in cadets. My 5, 6, I don't know. You lose count after 5 years in cadets. Thank you again. And I wish you the luck in the rest of your cadet years.
Hi, this is Flight Sergeant Hutchinson. I want to thank the staff for helping me succeed and pushing me to do my best. Good luck to the other graduating cadets and to the returning cadets. You get out of this program what you put into it. Have fun with your cadet career.